Good morning, everybody. It is Tuesday, so talk Tuesday, real Tuesday this week, not fake Tuesday like last week. We are at the straight road today.
It is
absolutely beautiful. I know it says it's cold, but in the sunshine, and it's quite nice. And so we have Phoebe and Murphy, Denver, Hamish, and Saxon. Out! Murphy, Denver, go on.
Let's go.
Thank you. All right. Child, contrary to your color, you are not a cow. Stop eating grass. So yeah, straight road. We're almost halfway through walk. We had to pass a person today. And I did my usual process of I recalled everybody, leashed them all up, and we pulled off to the side just because I could sort of tell by the way the oncoming person was walking that maybe not the best control of their dogs. And they had a full-grown boxer on a flat collar and a flexi. And immediately I was like, okay, well, that says to me pull over more than anything else. So it kind of got me thinking. She had tons of compliments about your dogs. She was very impressed. And she, like, so you can see the road is pretty wide. If the person seems okay with it, then I'll just stay on the road and make sure we all stay, like, over schmeh. But if I have any concerns, then I wait for, like, a gap in the grass like this. And I just pull everyone off to the side. I put them all in a sit or a down. And we just do that. But one of the things she said is, like, thank you so much for giving us space. Indicated the boxer, said she wasn't very friendly, and I could deduce that for myself, honestly, just based on the body language, like fighting the leash, giving no respect to the person who had the leash, and carrying on and stuff. And the other dog she had, which was also on a flexi, was a Boston Terrier, and same thing. Just they weren't dogs that I wanted your dogs to experience. And she asked how I got them all to behave. I was like, well, if they don't behave, then they don't get to walk, like, not freely anyway. Murphy, speaking of walking freely, and it's just a matter of training. Like, she was also impressed that I had them all on slip leashes. Because as you guys know, like, with COVID, I've been using my own gear. Murphy! Truthfully, even before COVID, I used my own gear. Mostly so that I wouldn't lose leashes and collars. Which is a thing. And I said, like, for me, a slip leash is one of the best tools. It grants you a heck of a lot more control and communication than a flat collar and a flexi leash. Like, I don't use flexi leashes on my dogs. I think there's a time and place for them. I also think you need to train. Like, you can't just put your dog on a flexi leash and expect them to know what the rules are. You have to teach them the rules. I used to use one with my very first dog. Sorry, it's gonna get loud in here. I used to use one with my very first dog. It was one of the ribbon ones. And here's the thing. If you are going to use a flexi leash. Okay, that's wind. We're turning around. Turning around. If you are going to use a flexi leash, I do ask that you use the ribbon one and not the one that is basically a string. Denver, you're killing me here, bud. Denver, go. Oh, I see what's happened. Hold on. Close up of Denver's bum. Sorry about that. Okay, go, go. Go on. I have unstuck you. Now I've stuck myself. Okay. All right. Yeah, so if you are going to use one, use the ribbony one, not the string one. A lot of injuries have been caused by those things. They terrify me. I don't know if you've ever got one, you might have noticed and probably discarded the little pamphlet that comes with it. If you ever have a chance to look at that pamphlet, I mean, it's lengthy. And there's a reason for that. It's because it's all like the safety stuff and legal things saying that they're not responsible for any injuries or up to and including death. Sort of like a gym membership. So that's like, that's the contract you enter into when you decide to use a flexi leash. And don't get me wrong, I think they can be great tools, especially if you're hiking, to allow your dog a bit more freedom. But I mean, there's also long lines, which I utilize a lot. They're what I train with, they're what I'm used to. And even e-collars, like an e-collar is basically an invisible leash. As long as it's used appropriately. I'm not like, don't go out, buy an e-collar, strap it to your dog, and same with a flexi. Don't buy a flexi, strap it to your dog, and think they know what's up. Like, just like anything else, it needs training. But yeah, so I basically wanted to have a PSA about flexis today, I guess. Like, there are some tools that I typically don't use. Flexis are one of them, harnesses are another. Now, you will notice I do have a harness on Kronk. I have a little vest one. And that's because that's what I attach his long line to when he's walking with me. Then I have him on a slip leash for now. We'll see. Like, he's been really good with a slip leash, so I don't think I'll do anything, but I like training my dogs on pretty much every training tool, just to make sure they're comfortable with different things. So we'll see how it goes. But yeah, that's my please don't use a flexi, it grants you little to no control speech. And again, if there's a time and place for it, if you're using it, just make sure you train your dog for it. That is to say, like, they don't pull on it, and they do recall when you tell them, and you don't have to pull them to you with the flexi. I had a really scary brief story time before I sign off. I had a very scary situation when I was a kid. First dog, Bouvier de Flandre, if you don't know what that is, it's a 120-pound black dog that looks sort of like a schnauzer in a haircut, but is beefier. Come on, kids, let's go. And down the street from us lived a family that at the time I was friends with the girl. We had a couple of run-ins when it came to the dogs, but the specific one I'm thinking of is they used to have two Shar Pei's, very poorly trained in retrospect, like they did basically nothing with them. And then tried to walk them, and they had, of course, these like teeny tiny flexies that they walked them on, basically like ones that would have been more appropriate for Hamish or Phoebe weight wise. And they had these Shar Pei's on them, and the male Shar Pei broke the leash, like the string popped out of it. He was pulling so hard to attack Zeus, my dog, who I was walking at the time. That was my very first introduction to advocating for my dog, and didn't end well for the Shar Pei, because my fight or flight instinct does appear to always be fight, and I basically, like, I pinned it until the owner, who was screaming at me, by the way, and I would have been no more like 12 or 13 around. and Zeus was just a puppy. They finally took their dog. And from that day forward, Zeus was not a fan of Sharpay's. I can't say I blame him. So that, having that experience with a flexi definitely sort of colors my, and I've heard from clients other stories that are along a similar line, so I'm a fan of the flat leash. So that's my my somewhat rant and PSA. I was hoping to get you guys some zoomies today, but it's nice outside and they're more interested in like investigating literally all of the smells happening because we haven't been here for a while. And all the dirt clumps, which you can see. Anyway, so that's it for me today. I'll also be posting a pup date later. Where's everybody? There we go. So we'll see that. As per usual, if you have questions about this or any other video, you know what to do. Otherwise, I hope you guys are having as much fun as your dogs are. I'll talk to you soon. Cheers.